What's happening, everyone? Viraga here, and today we're going to talk about 5 ways to purify water in an emergency situation that might save your life one day. Or you can just be cool and show it off to your friends. Now, before we start, I wanted to remind you guys that this is going to be a survival situation, and every scenario is going to be different. There are things that you can improvise and use differently to make these methods work the best for you. So with that being said, let's start. Number one, you might know that boiling water is probably the best and safest way to make water safe to drink. Now, if you're in a situation that you can easily make fire and you have regular water bottles laying around, you can easily get some dirty water, boil it in the same water bottle, and make it safe to drink. Yes, as long as there's water in your container, it won't melt. Now, keep in mind that the bottle will shrink a little bit, but it won't leak or anything. Just be careful for it not to tilt or tip over. Again, the reason why the water bottle is not melting is because there's water. So make sure to fill up the water bottle all the way to the top. Once you start seeing the bubbles, go ahead and pick up the water bottle with 2 sticks, put it on the ground or lean it towards something till it cools down and the water is ready to drink. Now, keep in mind that there are chemicals in this water now from the plastic that are not safe for you. So only do this in an emergency situation. Number two, bleach is an item that you can pretty much find in any household, and you can actually disinfect a lot of water with bleach. All you need to do is to add about 8 drops per gallon and let it sit for 30 minutes and your water is ready to go. Before you drink it, go ahead and smell the water. See if you can smell the chlorine. If not, go ahead and add another 8 drops and let it sit for 15 minutes. And this time, you probably should be fine. Number three, use a big trash bag to fit as many green branches as you can in that trash bag and let it sit for hours. The water in the leaves will evaporate and will have nowhere to escape. Therefore, it will stay in that trash bag. And after hours and hours, you might accumulate a little bit of water. Now, I recommend if you're gonna use this method, and if you have more trash bags, go ahead and find more trees and use them as well, just because this method uses absolutely no effort and you can leave them on for days if you're in a situation like that. Number four, solar steel. You might have heard about this method. What it does is basically it uses sunlight to evaporate, cool, and store water into a small container. Now, for this method, you need to dig a hole in the ground, and depending on where you are, you can fill it up with leaves, with green leaves, or if you're by the beach, you can just use wet sand. Put your collecting can right in the middle and cover it with a big sheet of plastic formed like a cone so that you can direct the water straight into the container. Now, this will also take several hours to accumulate some water, and it's not that efficient. So only use this method as a last resort. Number five, and the last method, is called the SODIS method. This method, again, uses sunlight and its UV rays to disinfect the water. Now, what you need to do, using a piece of cloth, go ahead and filter out some of the dirt out of the water, then pour it into smaller containers. Yes, this method requires you to have smaller container. I've read some articles that say this method works all the way to 2 to 3 liters per bottle, but if you can access smaller water bottles, I would think it's better and easier and safer to put it in smaller water containers and leave it out for the day. Now, they say this takes up to 6 hours to disinfect the water in the bottle, but I would recommend putting it out there for the whole day just to make sure you're safe. All right, guys, that's it for me. Hope you never have to use these methods in your lifetime, but it's good to know and it's fun to share it with your friends, show off, and look cool. Thank you for watching. If you liked the video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. If you're not subscribed to my channel already, go ahead and subscribe to support this channel, and I'll see you guys in the next video.